Hello, this is Cal from DJ School UK, here with another video. We've already done two videos before this one. Hopefully you've managed to get comfortable with the controls and how to beat matches making a little bit more sense. Like always, in the description of this video are links to a really handy PDF with all the keyboard shortcuts and links to get the free Serato DJ Lite software, which if you're watching this video and you don't have the Serato DJ Lite software, pause this video and get it downloaded. Before we get into it, I want to remind you that in these videos we talk fast and pack in information, but you can rewind and rewatch any part over and over until you understand it. Please use that comment section below to ask us questions. All comments are 100% moderated for safety purposes. And in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to find the one when it's not clear, when is it a good time to do your mix, and how to organise a crate. Alright, so first things first. These are the songs that we've been using, House Every Weekend and Just Be Good To Me. You probably don't have the same songs as me, but if you do, congratulations, man. Here's a virtual gold star. Normally, when we're mixing these two songs in previous videos, we've had House Every Weekend playing and we're mixing Just Be Good To Me. But we're going to flip that today. So we're going to actually be starting with Just Be Good To Me and then mixing in House Every Weekend. Little quick top tip. It's kind of good to mix your songs the other way around because sometimes it might sound better. And sometimes it'll highlight some problems that you're going to have mixing the songs. Let's get House Every Weekend loaded on side two. And we'll get Just Be Good To Me loaded on that side. So if you've watched Jim's video, which you should have by now, I'm going to mix these two songs together. And to do that, I need to make sure my speed is the same. So I'm going to move my BPM counter upwards. Come on. It's getting there. It's getting there. It's going away. It's a bit fiddly, this. Oh, God, you're all going to be laughing at me in the comment section. Come on. There we go. Easy as pie. And what I'll be doing, obviously, like Jim says, is I'll be counting 1, 2, 3, 4 and pressing play on the one. By now, you should know that W and S is your play buttons. I and K is your cue buttons. Okay, so let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Play. 2, 3. So that wasn't sounding good. I've hit I and K just to jump straight back. Yeah, the reason why that wasn't sounding good, even though I did everything right, is because House Every Weekend isn't starting from a 1. So when we've loaded in House Every Weekend, it started from its automatic play point, which is right here. Let's just have a quick listen to the intro. One more time. Yeah, so it starts with this little reverse sound here. And then the first drum hit is right here. So I'm going to move grab the track, and I'm going to move it up to that white line, just like that. And then I'm going to hit K and set my cue point there. Nice. Now, what I'm going to try and do is mix these songs together just to make sure they work. But before doing that, what I need to do is I need to check that my cue point is actually set correctly. And to do this, what I like to do is I like to play the song, count along with it, cue the song, but I'm going to carry on counting out loud, and then I'll try to get the song to come back in on my one. If that works, then I'm pretty confident it'll be a one. All right, so be like this. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm pretty confident that's a one, so I'm just going to give this a quick mix. 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Bit of a nudge. And then I'm going to fade out the first song. And fade out the second song. So, yeah, they definitely now mix together. But how was that mix? It was a mix. But we only listened to about 30 seconds of Just Be Good To Me. So let's have a look at some other mixing points to make it a little bit more interesting. So yeah, we're gonna probably start with the most obvious one, and you probably guessed it. It's intro-outro mixing. And what this is exactly what it says on the tin. When we reach the outro of Just Be Good To Me, we'll beat match House Every Weekend's intro over the top of it. Okay, so I'm gonna skip towards the outro here, just so I don't have to torture you with listening to the whole song and not make this video a million minutes long. So let's just give it a whirl. And this for this, we're not actually going to use the faders. We're just going to let the song finish and let House Every Weekend take over. All right, so let's give it a whirl. 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Nice. So I'm going to give it a little bit of a nudge. Okay. And now we're just going to let these two songs blend together. So just for good to me, finishing. And House Every Weekend took over. I can pause, just for good to me. And I'll play this in there. So that was intro outro mixing. Very easy, very simple to do. You know, you don't really have to do too much apart from get the songs in time. Problems you might occur with this really is that is that when you've got a really long song, you and your audience, you might not actually want to listen to the whole song. But it is an acceptable way of mixing, and I do suggest that you try it. All right, sweet. So that was intro outro mixing. Now we're going to try and find a way to avoid listening to the whole entire song of, you know, five minutes, 26 seconds. That's quite long. Some people could find that quite boring. I think as a DJ, you know, maybe I'd find that a little bit boring too. So we need to try and find a different place to do a mix. And, you know, that would be, for me, a bridge or a break. So what is a bridge or a break? A bridge or a break is a section of a song where it has an extended drum break or another solo thing happening for a long period of time. Remember that every bridge and break is different in some way, shape, or form. Some can be long, some can be short, some can be fast, you know. They all change, and some songs don't even have a break or a bridge, but if they do, they tend to be really good points to do a mix. So identifying where a break or a bridge happens, it can kind of happen anywhere, you know, especially when it's with big changes, you know, you could have multiple. But commonly, you'd find it around the middle of your song. So I can see on here now that this is Just Be Good To Me's bridge or break. So let's just give it a quick click over here and let's have a listen, just so we know what it sounds like. That's the wrong song. Let's have a listen. So here's the change, you can hear it building up. And it starts there. So this point is where I'm going to choose to do the mix. So I'm just going to quickly reset, just like this. And what I'm going to do now is when we reach that point of the break or bridge, I'm going to start the intro of House Every Weekend and just see how it goes. And for this, I will be using the volume fader. Okay, so let's hit play. Nice. All right, so I'm getting ready on the volume. Sounds nice and clean. Start fading it down. Allowing House Every Weekend to start taking charge. Lovely. And then I can stop that song. And let House Every Weekend play. Yeah, does that make sense? So that was mixing over the break or bridge. However, when you're mixing over the break or bridge, you might find that you go through your songs faster. So it's a good idea to sort of mix in various different ways. So practice intro, outro mixing, and practice mixing over the break or bridge, just to sort of vary up the length of mixes. Now, that was all well and good, you know, but I do think House Every Weekend's intro is a little bit too long, okay? So I want to do that break mix again, but I want to change where House Every Weekend starts. So to do that, I'm just going to give it a quick skip over here. And I'm going to line myself up with this one. Now, I've tested this already, so I do know this is a one. And I'm just going to move my cue point by pressing K. Lovely. So we're going to try it again, but this time, because my intro, I've cut my intro now, so my mix is going to be a little bit, it's going to be a little bit quicker. So I'm actually going to use the crossfader for this. This is going to allow me to cut a little bit faster. The crossfader essentially tells you what side you're listening to. So if it's on this side, you'll hear Just Be Good To Me. If it's on this side, you'll hear House Every Weekend. And if it's in the middle, you'll hear both. All right, so let's give this mix a quick go. I did it again, wrong song. And volume up, comments killing me. Right. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, get on the crossfader. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Cut.
When it comes to house every weekend.
All right, yeah, so I can do this.
When it comes to house
and fade down. All right, so I actually liked that a little bit better just because it was a little bit faster. We got into the track nice and quick. So House Every Weekend wasn't just rolling over. We got straight into its meat and bones. So that can be quite nice, especially if you wanted to keep the energy going. So I have one last thing to sort of go over. And that is that you're probably now finding that your crate down here is getting chock-a-block with songs just because you keep adding loads, or you might want to organize them in a certain way. So I'm going to show you quickly just how to organize them. All right, so there's a few things. You might have a few more things you can click. You can, you know, if you right click, you can add all these different things. You don't really need all of them, if I'm honest with you. But commonly I will organize by BPM. So lowest to highest, or highest to lowest. I'll do it by song, A to Z and Z to A, but most times I'll use the hash symbol, and that will allow me to drag my songs into any order that I want. So if I'm making like a little bit of a skeleton for a crate, or a little bit of a planned mix maybe sometimes, I will use that method. So yeah. I've probably overstayed my welcome. I hope you found this video useful. Remember, you can rewind this video as many times as you want. Keep practicing and keep enjoying your music. Keep them eyes peeled, coming for another video soon. And if you like this video, hit the thumbs up button. Subscribe so you know when we upload new videos. And if you have any questions or ideas about future videos, leave us a comment. If you want one-to-one online classes, or you want to donate to DJ School UK's non-profit work, there's links in the description for that as well. Thank you so much, and enjoy your music. See ya.